So 2.5 weeks ago, I had just turned in my nomination papers and I had a great meeting. Came home and found out the car fire had jumped the Sacramento River. At that point, I knew we as a city and as a community had a serious problem on our hands. My wife and I, with our three young children, went over to a friend's house, and from the rooftop, I could see the fire coming into the city. It was a terrifying moment. I was afraid, and I felt really, really powerless. That's what vulnerability feels like. Sometimes we choose to be vulnerable, and sometimes something happens that forces us to be vulnerable. There's still a lot of people that feel vulnerable in the city, people that are trying to figure out how to rebuild their homes, but there's also people that are emotionally still feeling very vulnerable. There's people that are financially very vulnerable. Those subdivisions, they had people coming in to take care of their lawns and their pools and do the home remodels. And that source of income is how people were paying rent and mortgage and buying groceries for their family. And we need to keep that in mind. But here is the silver lining. Vulnerability is a key and fundamental building block of relationships. And I'd like to submit to you as evidence, the relationships that you've built in the last few weeks since the car fire is probably about the same amount of relationships and the debt that you've built over the last 2 to 3 years. Being vulnerable really expedites the process of developing relationships. It's my goal as a person to maintain vulnerability. In my relationship with my wife, the depth and closeness that we have and we enjoy wouldn't be there if we weren't willing to be vulnerable with each other. So I want to encourage you to continue being vulnerable. That's what these videos are all about. It's about being vulnerable to the community. Knowing that I don't have all the answers, listening to your feedback, to your comments, trying to respond to you, not just attaching my name or an idea to a tragedy, but to try to have a conversation about it in a meaningful way. And this is what I truly believe. As horrible as the car fire was, the end result of our community is going to be better and stronger because we will continue to look for people that are vulnerable and we will continue to support them. And when we feel vulnerable, it's okay because people are there to support us. And that's what being a community member is all about.